Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2063 of our daily nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala, we focus on the 18th of Zulhijjah. It was on the 18th of Zulhijjah, the year 35 after Hijrah, corresponding to 17 June 656, Sayyidina Amirul Mu'mineen, Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu departed from this world. Who is Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu? He became the Khalifa on the 1st of Muharram in the year 24. So 12 years he ruled this Ummah. Secondly, he is Dhun-Nurayn. He is the son-in-law of the Master Habibuna Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam twice. First, Sayyida Ruqayya radiallahu anha, the beloved daughter of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was in his nikah. After her demise, then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he should marry Kulthum radiallahu ta'ala anha, and therefore he is known as Dhun-Nurayn, the only person in human history from Nabi Adam alayhi salam right till the day of justice that he got married to two daughters of a Nabi, one after the other. The first one passed away and then the other. The Qibla in Medina Munawwara, Masjid Nabawi, is the southern direction where the front mihrab is, the niche where the Imam stands. That extension was done by Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu. In the Battle of Tabuk, 300 camels, 1,000 gold coins. Subhanallah, who can forget all this of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu? The well, Bir-e Ruma, donated to the Muslims by Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu. So may Almighty Allah grant him the highest stages in Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la. It was on the 18th of Zulhijjah 1393, the 12th of January 1974. 12th January 1974, Libya and Tunisia announced that they are merging as Islamic Arab Republic. But as you know, that always these countries, they all suffer from ana khayrun min, that I want to be the big boss, I want to be better than you, hence then everything disintegrates, and therefore it didn't last very long. Similarly, on the 18th of Zulhijjah 1375, corresponding to 27th of July 1956, the Egyptian leader Jamal Abdel Nasser, he announced the nationalization of the Suez Canal Company. This announcement led to Britain, France and Israel becoming the enemies of Egypt, because you must remember that now they felt that their income and so forth will be less and so forth. And anyway, it didn't prove to be very successful for Egypt there to nationalize it, because you must remember, once you do things like this against these enemies of Islam and humanity, they will always undermine you. And that is what happened, you must remember, that then Jamal Abdel Nasser went away, Anwar Sadat came, and so many, Husni Mubarak, all of them tinpot dictators, if you ask me, you must remember that, like the current one also, another dictator, very little to do with Islam and so forth and so on. So therefore, we need to understand that these people are handpicked by the West to serve their interest, and once they feel they were going against the West, then they will get rid of them. So may Almighty Allah Jalla Wala give us that wisdom, that we must choose our own leaders, not the enemies choose our leaders. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.